conjunction.
Oh, yeah.
Customer Gonzalez obviously lives here. So she was, she commuted the easy way. She just walked over. But wanted to have this stuff. I know people are out there that we're here to see if business owners in the junction.
Yes.
What's working, not working? What do we need for public safety? And we'd love to hear from you guys. Any questions, any thoughts, any comments?
I have a comment. My name is Mike Quinn. I live here at the junction. I work at Sally University. I take the bus into town. I walk up the hill out here. And I see these young men sleeping on the street more every year, it seems like. And I know you're working on it, but I wish we could do something to help the homeless quicker, because it just seems to be getting worse every year. We're a great city, and it seems like we're too great to have a problem like this.
Thank you for that. I mean, I will tell you. All right. I haven't seen you for a I hear, and I don't know about Councilman Gonzalez, but I hear two things when I go in and part of the city. One is people are concerned about homelessness and what they see as a growing problem. But at the same time, I hear everybody say, how do we make it better? The good news is we actually have housed currently more people than ever before in the city of Seattle. We're about 35% ahead of where we were this time last year. We increased the number of shelter beds by almost 25% in the last 3 months. We've created almost 500 new shelter spots. But what we're seeing is more and more people are falling into homelessness. It's one reason why I partnered with Dow Constantine and the mayors of the other cities, and I talked to Jay Inslee to say, how do we get regional and statewide responses? Because so much of homelessness is a reflection of the increasing wage disparity and changes in economy and poverty. So we know we have to do both things. We know we have to address public safety concerns that people have in the field, but we can do it in a humane way to make sure that we provide safe places for people to be, provide treatment for, whether it's substance abuse or mental health problems, but we actually give people real treatment for those things. That's going to require the state and the county, because they control those revenues. So I think working together, and the city council right now is considering the budget to try to take that whole list of you. And then the last big thing we know we need in this area is we need more affordable housing. And we need it not just for low-income housing, we need it for middle-income. And we've been having a lot of conversations at the state, county, and city level. How do we do that? Not just government, but private industry, to harness people together to actually provide more housing as quickly as we can in the city of Seattle.
Thanks.
Chiming in on him, my name is Katie Campbell. I'm a Seattle native, and I've lived in this neighborhood for 20 years. And adding to what he said, something that I want you to hear, because it's not really a pretty thing to say, but I'll be brave enough to say it, is that I have every want to take care of homeless people that have contributed to the city of Seattle. My fellow brothers and sisters and neighbors contributed to this community, and then came on hard times, became ill, cancer, death in the family, those kinds of things that make things happen when they lose their home. What really disturbs me is about how open arm Seattle is about financing the homeless of people that are coming in from other parts of the country. And I know they're coming. I mean, we've even seen them on the news. They get reported they've fallen on some kind of hardship, and they've only lived in state for 3 months. And they get on television for something that's happened to them, the problem happened, and then they got here, and they're taking advantage of our bleeding heart community. And I don't want to pay for that as a taxpayer. I want to take care of our people here in Seattle. I want to take care of my neighbors, but I don't want to be supporting programs that don't make some sort of check on if you live here, if you pay taxes here, your family. That bugs me. Really bad.
Yeah. Well, I appreciate you saying that, and I think being able to say we